Today I'm looking at an old Channel Master Model 6248 multi-band radio. And this was something of a barn find. A friend of mine found this in a barn. But it was being used by its previous owner on a somewhat regular basis in that barn, periodically to listen to ball games and things like that. So I knew that at least the AM broadcast band on this radio worked. And I assumed that everything else did too, but I haven't really gone through the radio yet. I've just kind of obtained it. So I thought maybe I'd turn the camera on and kind of go through the radio for the first time. So here's just a basic overview of the radio before I get into trying any of the features out or anything. You can see that it's a fairly large radio to begin with. Here's a standard pencil, and you can kind of see how big the radio is in relationship to the pencil there. So it's a good sized radio, nice and heavy, and it's got a pretty solid handle on the top there. You can see here on the main display that this is an 8-band radio, and as such it's got 8 bands there that you can select from using these switches on the top. It's got a volume control and a tone control. And one of the most interesting features of this radio is that it has a BFO that you can switch in and out, meaning that you can receive sideband signals with this, as well as CW. But you could switch that in and be able to receive sideband. In conjunction with this fine tuning knob, you'd be able to tune in the stations. It's got a squelch, which is also an interesting feature, but probably a useful one, since this does receive well up into the VHF high band, or at least according to the front panel it does. And then it's got a basic tuning knob here, which you can see has been used fairly well over the years. Maybe it's not real apparent in the video here, but the chrome is all worn off of that tuning knob, so this radio has definitely been used. The front of the radio should have a protective cover that goes over it and closes it up, although that cover is missing, but you can see the hinges for it down here on the bottom. They look like they're in good condition. I'm not sure what would have happened to the cover, but that's long gone now. And then in addition to that, there are a couple of rabbit ear antennas, which I'll kind of fold down here. You can see these are just your standard telescoping antennas, although these are fairly hefty. They feel pretty rugged, but the tip of this one here that I'm moving around, I may not be able to show it in the video just because of the angle, but the tip of this one is broken off at the end, but the other one is in good shape, and they're not bent, and they still kind of function and collapse in and all that sort of thing. Just the tip of this one is broken off. Okay, so we'll take a quick look at the back here of the radio. And you can see on the bottom here, there is a battery compartment, but there is no battery door with the radio, nor is there a battery holder. The missing battery holder looks like it would plug into this plug, and the battery holder itself should be able to contain 6 D cells, at least according to the label back here. So in addition to that, there are also some antenna input jacks. This is an FM antenna arrangement here. You could use a 300 ohm antenna or use this shorting bar for the internal antennas, which of course is what's set up now. Over here is an antenna connector for shortwave, the public service band, the air band. And then over here is a connection for EP. And then this last jack over here is EP/SP, which leads me to believe this would be for an external speaker. Okay, and then just a quick zoom in on the label here. This is as far in as I can zoom. But you can see the Channel Master Model 6248. Power supply, you can use 9-volt 6 D cells, or you can use the built-in AC power supply. No serviceable parts inside, and then over here is a list of those non-serviceable parts, at least the more important ones anyway. The 24 transistors, 2 of them for squelch, 1 for the BFO, 1 for a voltage regulator, 13 diodes, and 2 thermistors. So some marketing person somewhere thought that that would impress somebody. And then over here you've got the frequency ranges that the radio can receive. The standard FCC disclaimer for part 15. Those are the basic specs of this radio. One other thing to note about this radio is that I noticed this bottom cover here is sort of broken. The screw holder looks like it popped out. I'm guessing this thing was dropped at one point and this just broke off, but it doesn't seem to affect the radio that much. It still is kind of held together, and I believe that it still functions okay. There shouldn't be any problem with it working, so it's just something to keep an eye on. So now I'll just go through some basic operation of the radio, I guess, just to see kind of how well it's working across the bands. So I'll activate that switch to start off on the long wave band, which apparently covers 200 to 400 kilohertz. Now, I doubt that I'll hear anything on that band, being down here in the cellar. It's about 9:30, 10 o'clock at night, and I don't have an external antenna on this right now. So I don't expect to hear much on there, but maybe we'll hear some static or the overhead lighting or something like that. So first thing I'll do is power it on, and I'll bring the volume up a bit. And of course, these controls, I'm sure, need to be cleaned. But there you can kind of hear some 60-cycle hum, which is to be expected, especially with these lights. And I'll just kind of quickly scan up the band here and see if there's anything to hear. So, as expected, not much going on the long wave. Now I'll switch up to the AM band, and we'll start at the top of the band and work our way down. So right away you can hear some stations.
He said, "I pray me a little water in a vessel so that I may drink."
The exact meaning of this concept is simply bread for the coming day.
Be the peanut butter to your jelly. Visit cdwg.com/Dell to get even more value from your Dell technology. Dell and CDWG.
Okay. So there's Fall River, Massachusetts. That right there is probably WTIC out of Hartford, Connecticut. That should be about the closest station to this location, although it's not coming in the strongest, but it is there.
At ctlighting.com, featuring Kichler Showroom Lighting. And for restoration and repair, unique fixtures.
Based on the accent of the person talking there, I'd almost have to guess that that was a Canadian station. But it seems like it's faded out now.
He found the seals in a library book somewhere in Toronto. You know what that means.
Saturday night, and it is not football. This is Mark Weber, always in fashion, and we are discussing the Super Bowl of fashion, or more correctly, the advertising and commercials of the Super Bowl in fashion. It's Fashion Week is gone.
This sounds like it might be a little bit of an interesting program. I'll have to come back here.
Period in the season for new creative advertising is the September issue.
Fastball up and eminently drivable.
There's a strong station. Not sure what that one would be.
All he didn't get is in his head.
It might be, that might have been WABC out of New York City. I think that's 770. I'm not sure. Maybe it was 730 WOR. I'm not really up on my AM stations these days.
Rutgers lost to Iowa and in the Ivy League.
Another strong one.
Princeton, Yale, all in the loss column. Weather reports every 20 minutes. Mike McCann, WFAN, 2020 Sports.
There's WFAN.
Cold, not that interested in you. We have state-of-the-art technology you'd want from your bank. But our technology is...
From the medieval horrors to the modern technology...
So I'm starting to feel a little binding in the tuning knob there. But it still seems to be moving okay. It just must have hit a tight spot. There's a French station. I'd have to guess that's out of Quebec somewhere. Maybe Montreal. Now we're getting down the bottom of the band. So as you can see, this thing's working pretty well on AM. It's pulling in quite a few stations down here in the cellar. No problems at all. In fact, there's so many stations there that some of them are on top of the others. So I'm quite impressed with the AM broadcast band on this thing. Could spend some time playing around with that, I'm sure. Okay, so next I'll switch up to Shortwave 1 band, which looks like it starts around 4 megahertz, which may put it down here in the ham band a little bit. So there's a station of some kind there.
The poor person and the multiples, that now today with psychotronics, they can really put you under a stupor.
This sounds like a coast-to-coast type paranormal thing or something. I'm hoping to find something on sideband so we can test out that BFO. There's a strong one there.
English reports that he was blackmailed $850,000 to keep damaging information away from the IRS. There's a post from Fox News a couple years ago. Next step is like contact all your donors in the IRS.
So here's some conspiracy talk. There's WHR.
While people in Kazakhstan are free to host gatherings of...
Radio Ukraine International on the old channel master down here in the cellar with no antenna. Not bad.
Radio Miami International, Okeechobee, Florida, USA, and www....
So there you go, WRMI.
Send us your comments and responses. reception reports to info@wrmi.net or by regular mail to WRMI, P.O. Box.
Okay, so we switched over to Shortwave 2. I'll work my way down. Now, I doubt we're going to hear much on those bands, because we're up around 21, 22 megahertz, and with no antenna, and there's probably no activity there tonight anyway, although I am hearing some kind of noise there, and I don't know if that's the wireless router or something starting to show up. So we got one station there anyway. Maybe another one down there at the bottom. So, it's working. I'm getting a little bit of activity there, but not a whole lot. Okay, so I'll move up to public service band number one, which is actually the VHF low band, starting from 30 megahertz up to 50. Now again, with no external antenna, and probably very little activity in that band in this area anymore, I don't expect we're going to hear anything. So I'm just going to kind of slide up there kind of quickly. So the next band is the FM band, but I'll skip that one for now, and I'll go straight to the air band. And you can see that's 108 to 135. Now I don't know my aircraft frequencies around here either. The closest airport is Bradley Airport in Windsor, Connecticut, and that's maybe 25 miles or so west of here. But I don't recall any of the frequencies over there offhand. Of course, as I get done saying that, we hear plane transmitting there. So that's interesting. I'm picking something up there. That almost sounds like tower traffic, but I'm not sure what airport that would be. Okay, now I'll switch over to public service band 2, or VHF high. I'll work my way down. I doubt I'm going to hear much up here either, being this time of night. Although once I get down here, I might be able to pick up some of the weather stations. So I'm hearing a weather station there. I'm not sure which one that is. It's struggling with that one. Now, you can see here this goes down to 147, so this may catch the top end of the 2-meter ham band, but my guess would be that none of the repeaters are active right now. Okay, so I'll go back to the FM band, and I'll kind of go through that one quickly. So I'll just scan up through that fairly quickly.
It's called Holy Key.
Okay.
And this is all about spitting in rhymes, man, rhymes. Let's get it. WHUS stores, man. Let's go.
There you go.
We the best. I'm the best. You the best.
So WHUS is probably the closest broadcast station of any station. When I put my hand on the antenna terminal back there, it did seem to come in a little better. Okay, so now we're getting some stations. Now that's interesting. I don't know if I'm getting an image there, or if I've got two stations playing the same song at the same time. Yeah, maybe it was just my head. Maybe they were just similar songs, not the same. I don't know.
Oh, yeah, that we didn't criticize them. Do you think we'd still be in the same situation we are right now? Or do you think we'd be better, worse, or we can't even say, so let's just be happy that we're where we're at right now?
Can't even say, so let's just be happy with where we're at right now. They got 91 wins.
All right, here we go. We got guys yelling at each other. That's jockstrap radio. So we're getting some performance here on FM. Maybe not quite as good as I would expect it to be, but it is working. I think maybe there's an issue with the antenna there or something. So I guess that's where I'll leave this video for tonight. If you enjoyed this video, I would appreciate a thumbs up. And if you'd like to leave a comment or subscribe to my channel, feel free to do that as well. Thanks for watching.